तो गाइस कैन बी स्टार्ट। कैन यू कंफर्म इफ यू कैन स्टार्ट? थैंक यू, थैंक फॉर कंफर्मेशन। सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग विद द इंटरप्राइज बैकअप एंड आई होप माय मशीन इज विजिबल टू यू। Can somebody confirm? So now we are going with the enterprise backup. Okay. So for the data, as we have created a my backup, whichever you want, you can create it accordingly. And then, can you click on the local instance? So first time when you are going to connect. For your machine, it is not coming properly. So what you can do, go to the database and over there, sorry, on the server, and here you have to click onto the MySQL Enterprise Backup. So you are getting the some error, am I correct? Can somebody share the screen if you are getting the error? Then you have to change the path. So by default, in your database, the path is into MySQL 5, where it is running the MySQL. Got it. So I checked and I changed to the my machine, that my.ini, if you remember. So that was on over there, we have checked. Then in the setting, you can see the MEV executable. So always once you choose the your version properly, you can get it. So if you are getting the issue, you can check over there, go to that path and choose the MySQL backup.exe. This is for the MySQL Enterprise Backup, which we have installed over there. If you can see in the MySQL, you have a Enterprise Backup. So this path I have chosen. Got it. And over there, you can see the bin directory and the MySQL backup.exe. Then in your machine, it is not coming the backup home directory. So always give the correct path where you need to perform the backup. So that's called the backup home directory. You can able to do it. And after the home directory, let me scroll down its bottom, you can see the output properly. Then it should ask you the username. So who is the user who will perform the backup? So by default, my backup or whichever the users you can able to do. If it is not there, so you have to create it. Got it? So here you can see create. It will ask you the my backup user, their password, whichever the user you want to take the backup, that can take the backup, and that's where you can able to. The password should be match as per the your. So here I am giving my name at direct 123. So that's where you can give it. And then you need to enable it. So you can see the enable button over there. So as a DBA, you need to enable the MSCBA account. So, and then vacate it. So what I did in my case, I have put onto the root user, and the same way from the root user, I am giving this, and I can able to take the backup. So this way you can do the your setting. So you click on the setting, you can find here is the your MySQL Enterprise Backup. In your case, it is not, nothing is there. It's a blank. on your machine because you have not created anything. So what I am going to do, I am creating a new job. So new job, what job you are going to create? So just example, I am creating the full backup. This is my job name. When you want the backup should be performed. Okay, so you can able to give the comments like this I want. This example, weekly. Weekly full backup. This example. Then you can choose here, perform the full backup every. I'm saying the full backup you need to perform on the week wise. And you need to take the backup onto the every Sunday at what time? So just example, morning 2 a.m. Just example. So this will do the full backup onto every Sunday. Got it? If you want incremental backup, you can take it. Otherwise, you can skip it. So I am taking only the full backup. Got it? Suppose I want to take the differential backup also, which is called incremental backup. So I can say, okay, every day, I'm saying the daily, you have to take the incremental backup after the business hour. So just example, I'm putting it 18. That means 6 p.m. in the evening, the backup will be performed. Okay. Now, come to the contents. Here, you can choose backup full content of the MySQL instance. So let me first delete here from this, whatever the backup we have, like the previous demo, what we have taken. So I'm just deleting it. So there's no old backup will be there. Okay, so I delete all the things from the my backup directory. There is no backup. So you can get the idea when backup will run. Because I'm taking the backup on that location. So backup full content of this my instance. So on the MySQL instance, do you want to the full database backup? So here, if you can see, we have a multiple databases. Got it? So you can able to take the backup of the entire instance wise. You can able to take the backup of a specific one. So those all way you can able to do. So backup full content of MySQL instance, yes. If you want to take the backup of the specific object, so you can see select object to be included. So it will give you the partial backup warning. You have to say, and then you have to choose. You have to give that path. Okay, in the world.ct. So what happened? In this case, in the world database, like, let me show. And then here is the table. So I can able to take the city table backup. So I can write like the world.city. Got it? So that's where you can see. I specify a regular expression match like a DB name dot table name, which you want to take the backup. So that's where you can able to write. But since I am taking the full backup, for the entire instance, so I have put into the first option. Even if legacy, like the older one, if you are using, you can able to customize. So in the older, like the earlier version 5.5 or those, it will come like this way. You can choose. But I'm taking the full instance level backup, so I'm putting here this. Then option. In option, what you want. So here, I am putting into the C drive backup, full backup. But you can see, we don't have the full backup like the name over there in the backup directory. So what happened? It will forcefully create it. Got it? So if it is not there, it will create. Then do you need to compress the backup? If you remember, I told you in the enterprise DB, you can able to compress the backup. So backup size will be reduced. You can able to use, but for that, non-incremental InnoDB backup only it will choose. Got it? So I'm not choosing it. If you want to take the log backup, So after the your backup, you want to take the log backup, so you can able to apply. But it is used for the incremental backup. Like suppose something is happening and then you are saying, okay, I need this or that, it can be used. If you want to skip unused page, you can able to do it. If you want to encrypt, so you can give the encryption password. This all will possible with enterprise edition. If you remember in theory, I told you these all the thing. I'm not taking that one, only I am taking full backup. And then we are taking after the backup, the log also. So point in time recovery will possible from there. And then in advance, if you want some things, you can able to do like the master enterprise backup command, or those all you can able to write if you want. So that's why I can able to save and schedule. So it will say, okay, I don't have a full backup. Can I create? Yes, you said create. That's it. So you have save and reschedule it. Got it. Once you clicked over there, let me cancel into this. And I can get over there the MySQL Enterprise. Let me close this because that's a internal thing. Now let me start the MySQL workbench again, and I can see that backup was scheduled. So I hope you all understood the concept. Let me give the password. And then if you can see in the your server, MySQL Enterprise backup, so that full backup is scheduled now. Got it. And then I can able to, when happen? So this backup will happen at the 26-9 as per my schedule. The Sunday will come on to that. If you can check on the calendar, you can get, so 26 is the Sunday and this will. But I don't want to wait for that. So that's why I am executing that. So I can able to execute now. So execute now means you can able to do the backup. You are not waiting till the Sunday. So manually once schedule is done, you can able to do. So you can see MySQL backup completed. Okay. You can see the logs and everything. So that's where it happened. If you want to take the only incremental backup, you can execute incremental, select a name and execute incremental. So this will start an incremental backup over there. So this is the time, if you notice where the backup and the what is the position, this is the locations, the full backup, then incremental it is created, the time and other things you can see. The today date and the time, 12:15, they have taken the backup. Okay. And now if I can see in the my backup directory, the backup has completed. So here you can see, now you have full backup, here you have incremental backup. That is as per the, your time, this is the, your incremental backup, your configuration file, your server configuration, and each and everything you can able to get it. So that's way the enterprise backup will work. I hope you all understood the concept. If anyone have any doubt, any questions, feel free to ask me. So that's where the full backup you can able to perform, and we able to do from the our command, the master slab, those all can be possible accordingly. Got the idea, guys? So giving you the time, you all can go test it. If any doubt, please let me know. Okay. So That's about our MySQL backup. So that is called MySQL Enterprise Backup. And based on that point in time recovery, you can able to do any table we can create, and then we can say, okay, I want to restore up to this time. So I will show you the restore also accordingly. So go ahead, do it, and let me know what's done.